I'm Chairman of the Board, Richard Hirsch. And to all of you, I proudly say shalom and welcome to Israel. Last month, we gathered around our Seder tables and declared next year in Jerusalem. Now, just over 2 weeks later, we're in Israel, far ahead of schedule. And an exceptional experience awaits us. I don't change, I'm the same person all the time. But I tell the joke. Months of planning have gone into the creation of the delegation itinerary, and I guarantee you will be a week none of us will ever forget. So rather than wait to the end, join me in expressing our appreciation to Business Development Vice President Zev Rubenstein. And National Director, Sarah Friedman. For the many weeks of planning, hard work, and preparation, they put into creating this memorable delegation. So I'll applaud them again. Ladies and gentlemen, the highlights of our visit will be the celebration of the Yom HaSmaot, Israel Independence Day. However, you may be unaware that our delegation coincides with another momentous celebration. And this I direct to you, the new members. Tomorrow, May 10th, marks 65 years to the day that David Ben-Gurion stood before thousands of cheering supporters at Madison Square Garden and announced the launch of the Israel Bonds Program. Were any of you there?
And by the way, the entrance was $5.
Sorry. That was the beginning of an enterprise that spread throughout the United States, onto Canada, and eventually across the globe. Today, the fruition of Ben-Gurion's vision can be seen right here in this room, with Israel Bonds leaders from three continents comprising the largest Bonds delegation ever. Together, we've shared in a worldwide success story that today has realized nearly over $40 billion in sales. I thank each and every one of you for being part of this historical event. Ladies and gentlemen, again, over the course of our delegation, we'll run the gamut of emotions: celebration and remembrance, connection, and solidarity. Highlights will include top-level meetings with the President and Prime Minister, the solemn remembrance of Yom HaZikaron, and the festive atmosphere of Yom HaTzma'ot. Through it all, we will share the collective honor of knowing we are helping to make a true difference for Israel. I know you'll be justifiably proud of your Israel Bonds involvement every day that we are here in Israel. I want to share a few Bonds success stories. First, the large contingent from Europe and Latin America underscores the success of the ongoing internationalization of Israel Bonds. While we've always had terrific overseas leadership, we've been in the process of bringing international offices fully in line with their respective countries' compliance and regulatory rules. We'll go off the script for a second, Zed doesn't like me to do. But
it's okay, he's done.
We were given a terrific challenge about 2 years ago, taking over the offices of England, France, Germany, Mexico, South America, and what?
Canada.
I'm sorry, but Canada we had before, but we basically oversee Canada as well. And I promised the government, put the money into what's needed to be done. Regulatory, legal. Tremendous amount of effort went into the preparation for getting ready, and quite honestly, true to our word, and Izzy's, and myself, and the staff, we met all the goals. It was a big expense, but it'll probably be one of the best returns on investment that certainly the finance ministry will ever have made. And gentlemen, thank you for your, you came later. Pleased to report there is now an active Israel Bonds presence in the UK, France, Germany, Brussels, as well as Canada, Mexico, and Brazil. We'll be expanding into additional countries in Europe and Latin America in the coming months. And once again, hats off to the staff that made this happen.
Cheers.
It really is very much appreciated. I'm not going to mention names because I'll probably forget somebody and will never talk to me again. To all the young leadership who have joined us, thank you for your involvement with Israel Bonds. I'm very proud to say that without reservation, we have perhaps the finest and most active new leadership division in the United States for any Israeli cause. And I'm not counting AIPAC. AIPAC is a different situation. But they have done, I saw the numbers this morning, I couldn't believe it. Jason, if I'm wrong in quoting some of your comments, but we have close to 10,000 new leadership on our roll and 2,500 very, very active leadership throughout the country. And that's a lot. I also learned something else, that new leadership is really 45 and under. So, you know, I'm not recruiting, Jason, but I want them to know that, you know, there's plenty of room for additional sponsorship and leadership. And they have done one hell of a job. Just as an aside, we had an event in New York where they asked me to attend, which I did, and they said, we're going to have 140 people there. New leadership, 140? Well, 250 showed up. So we had FHB, meaning family hold back, which we couldn't meet, but the kids did for their leadership. I also want to say that the continued achievements of Bonds Organization will be reflected in the expression of gratitude that we'll be hearing in coming days. The President, Prime Minister, and many more will express their sincere and heartfelt appreciation for the work that we've all done on behalf of the State of Israel. Now, as we get underway, I'm pleased to call on Izzy Tapuhi. As you know, Izzy has helped completely transform the Israel Bonds Organization. He brought a business-oriented approach to Israel Bonds, and based on his many years as one of Israel's leading executives. When Izzy first arrived at Bonds, annual U.S. sales averaged around $600 million. Today, they've grown to more than, what would you say, about $1.4
billion?
$1.1 in the U.S., but worldwide, what are we talking about?
$1.3 million.
Well, you can take credit for some of that, too. And then I saw the projections for this year, and I figured I ought to quit now while we're ahead, but okay. All told,
Andy, I'm not here.
Okay, he's a doctor, he's allowed to do that. In any event, before I introduce and have Izzy come up, I just want to make one recommendation that I thought about on the ride back from the Foreign Ministry today. Finance Ministry, I'm sorry. I was the foreigner. A few years ago, we started a program on these trips. And I had asked Bert Herbsman, Bert, where are you? To keep notes of different stops, the reaction. We worked with the French children on some of the problems they were having with anti-Semitism. We did a tremendous amount of visiting. We went to that same trip, we went to the Sharon Park, which is one of the great parks of the world. It's not on our itinerary today, but I urge you all to be there. It's probably three times the size of Central Park. It's a miracle in the process of happening, and a lot of it has happened already. But in any event, I asked Herb to collect notes, and we came back and wrote a report, which has been circulated to many, many thousands of people. And it did a lot of good, a lot of help, particularly with regards to the request of us made by the French children of their concerns about safety and security. This year, I'm going to urge you, take a fresh piece of paper, maybe tomorrow on the bus, can we afford a piece of paper for everybody?
A piece of paper for everybody?
No. In any event, put down your thoughts, your notes on a day-to-day basis. It really, you forget a lot, we do a lot, we see a lot. You might have suggestions, you might have some changes that we should make in the future. It's very important. And one thing that Bert does, he reads them, he takes them, he outlines them, he puts them in a priority position, he gets them to me, we do it, we publish something. And not necessarily giving credit to everybody who's on the trip and their comments, but it is a terrific guide for us to be able to see where we were and hope to know where we're going in the future. Okay, so that's a request. Okay, all right. Izzy, come on.
Once I feel very tall, by the way. Thank you, Richard, and good evening. I want to begin by expressing appreciation to all of you for your dedicated leadership. And the fact that you all are here with us, to me, adds